Hello everyone, welcome to RPIIT channel. My name is Vadini. I'm assistant professor in RPIIT Pastara in Computer Sciences Department. Today we are going to learn about one of the SDLC model, Software Development Lifecycle Model, that is Prototype Model. Prototype model is an activity in which prototypes of the software applications are created. First, a prototype is created and then a final product is manufactured based on that prototype. So in this model, the system is partially implemented before or during the analysis phase, thereby allowing the customers to see product early in the life cycle. The process starts by interviewing the customers and developing the incomplete high-level paper model, you can say. So prototyping is used to allow the users evaluate developer proposals and try them out before implementation. It also helps understand the requirements which are user specific and may not have been considered by the developer during software design. So this is the basic structure of prototype model. The prototype model is one of the most popular used software development lifecycle model. This model is used when the customers not basically know that what is the exact project requirements beforehand. So in this model, a prototype of the end product is first developed, tested and refined as per the customer's feedback repeatedly till the final acceptable prototype is achieved, which forms a basic for the developing of the final product. So this is the chart here. Let's discuss about the chart in the next slide. So what are the prototype phases? First one is requirement gathering. The first step of prototype model is to collect the requirements. Although the customer does not know much about the requirements, but the major requirements are defined in detail. The second phase is build the initial prototype. So in this phase, the initial prototype is being built and in which some of the basic requirements are displayed and user interface is made available. The next prototype is prototype phase is review the prototype. So when the construction of the prototype is completed, is presented to the end user or customer and the feedback is taken from them about this prototype. The next phase is revise and improve the prototype. When the feedback is taken from end users and customers, the prototype is improved on the basis of feedback. So what are the advantages of prototype model? That is increased user involvement in the product even before its implementation. Since a working model of the system is developed, is displayed, the user gets a better understanding of the system being developed, reduces time and cost as the defects can be detected much earlier phases. Quicker user feedback is available, leading to better solutions. Then missing functionality can be identified easily. Confusing or difficult functions can be identified. Then what are the disadvantages of the prototype model? So the basic risk disadvantage is the risk of insufficient requirements, because we don't have so much requirements in our initial stage only. So owing too much dependency on the prototype, users may get confused in the prototypes and actual systems. Practically, this methodology may increase the complexity of the system as scope of the system may expand beyond original plans. Developers may try to reuse the existing prototypes to build the actual system, even when it is not technically feasible. The effort invested in building prototypes may be too much if it is not monitored properly. So, prototyping, basically the disadvantage of the prototyping is very even costly also, and because of poor documentation in our first point only. So due to the poor documentation, that's continuously the customer is changing the requirements, so it increases the cost. So that's it for this prototype model. Do like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.